The Philippine Statistics Bureau earlier today held its third Philippine Identity Summit. Jackie Pascual is on the line with details of that event. Hi, Jackie. What can you tell us?
Hi, good afternoon, Sandy. The Philippine Statistics Authority asserted that the digital version of the national ID is as important as the physical ID. This comes amid a pause in the printing of the physical identification cards following the Banco Central ng Pilipinas' termination of its contract with All Card Inc. At the third Philippine Identity Summit in Quezon City, PSA Assistant National Statistician Emily Pagador said 55 million physical cards have been printed out of nearly 90 million registered Filipinos. That puts to 35 million the number of registered individuals without a physical card so far. But for Pagador, a digital ID works the same way as a physical card. And in fact, she said, in a digital world, people are now using mostly digital services. The digital ID can be accessed via the eGov mobile phone application. And Pagador said that establishments should accept the digital ID. If companies do not accept the digital version, she urged the public to report the company to the PSA. BSP, which is in charge of printing the national ID, has terminated its contract with ACI, citing failure to deliver its contractual obligations. BSP has said that ACI was supposed to provide the equipment, raw materials, and technical support. The issue is now under arbitration. Meanwhile, at the said summit, the Philippine Digital ID Experience Lab was also launched. It's a partnership among PSA, the University of the Philippines Diliman, and the modular open-source identity platform. And that's it, Stanley. Back to you.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Jackie Pascual.
Tropical depression Henner slightly intensifies while moving slowly. The storm was last spotted at 325 kilometers east-northeast of Kasiguran, Aurora. It is packing maximum sustained winds of 55 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 70 kilometers per hour. Several provinces in Luzon now under signal number 1, including Cagayan, Isabela, Quirino, Nueva Vizcaya, Apayao, Kalinga, as well as La Union, Pangasinan, and Aurora. Henner is expected to make landfall in the vicinity of Isabela or Aurora within the next 24 hours. Meanwhile, National Grid Operator NGCP says it has implemented precautions to minimize the impact of the storm on power transmission. Preparations include ensuring the reliability of communications equipment, as well as the positioning of line crews in strategic areas to facilitate immediate restoration work. Aboitiz InfoCapital is using its Lima estate in Batangas Province as the template for its expansion plans. Aboitiz InfoCapital's Monica Trajano reveals, Lima has seen a 5-7% appreciation in its market value in the last 1.5 years. She says the Lima blueprint will be applied to the company's latest industrial development, Tari Estate in Tarlac Province.
Lima is already almost 1,000 hectares, and you're correct, it's growing. And it's growing and driven significant economic growth in Batangas since its inception in 1993. In fact, it's generated 112 billion pesos in investments since then, since 30 years ago. It's created 71,000 jobs and growing also, which obviously benefits families in the provinces or in the province of Batangas by providing stable employment, boosting household incomes, and you're right. It's evolving into a center of commerce in Batangas. And we're expanding the industrial hub. What we have actually is an industrial anchored estate, which basically means out of the 1,000 hectares that we have, about 70% of that has industrial locators, and 30% is a CBD that we are growing.